name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Brothers and sisters, in your life, what opportunities have you had that you had to share some news with somebody? Perhaps it was a request or question of them in their life because you cared for them. They were special to you. And so you had to give them some news that was perhaps not an easy conversation to begin to have. Perhaps it was an elderly parent that you had to say, Mom, Dad, probably best not to drive anymore. Perhaps it was a child who was hanging out with the wrong crowd, and you asked them to change their crowd that they're hanging with, but the people that they socialize with. Perhaps it's a friend who has a very negative habit, perhaps drinking, drugs, something that is very affecting to them, and you tell them that they must give this up. There are numerous things that we probably have encountered in our lives where we had conversations with loved ones that are dear to us that were difficult. And when we pass that on to them, that news, it could be hurtful. Why do we do that? Why do we pass this news to people? Why do we bring it? Most of us might only do it if we felt our back to the wall. Most of the time we want to let it go. We want to mind our own business. But if we truly cared about the person, we'd probably want a way to intervene in their lives. It leads us to the gospel today of the rich young man, Christ. A very good man, one who knew his faith, who lived it out, who followed the commandments of the Old Testament, and was searching for salvation. And he comes to Christ and asks, what good deed must I do to enter eternal kingdom? And Christ had one of those moments, that intervention, that he had to share a request, some news to this man, because Christ loved him. He told him to take all that you have, sell it, give it to the poor. This was terrifying news to this young man. Because as we hear in the gospel, he had great possessions. He was wealthy. And this request of Christ was confusing to him. Was very confusing to him. One, we have to understand the time of the Jews, that the blessings that were earthly blessings given to people were often seen as God's favor for them. If they were well-to-do, if they've been blessed with earthly things, they understood God had been treating them above somebody else who was not. They were living their life right. This is not so different than a lot of Christian teachings that we hear today, that God will bless those who do this and this and this, and you will be given in abundance, overflowing. Well, we know, brothers and sisters, this is not the gospel. This is not the gospel. It's not what Christ taught in this very passage that we are hearing today. This man was sorrowful. He had possessions that he was attached to. And to follow Christ, to do that good deed, would mean that he would have to make a very difficult and uncomfortable change in his life, mainly being loosed from the possessions that bound him and giving away all his wealth that he thought God had instilled in him because he was living the proper life. This was his prescription, personal prescription. Christ gives us warning about wealthy people in this passage, but this is not what we need to reflect on. We don't need to worry about the situation of other people. Perhaps if we had an abundance of wealth, maybe we need to reflect on what that wealth does for us. What that possession, does it bind us? Does it enable, does it encumber us to follow Christ, to enter into the kingdom? We should ask ourselves that. But all of us should ask ourselves, what other than money? What other money distracts us from that one good deed of following Christ into the eternal kingdom? What is it, brothers and sisters? Us here today, most likely all of us profess to be Christians. We profess it. It is on our lips. We are Christians. But is that in our heart? Truly, truly in our heart, and not just on our lips. Oftentimes we confess to be Christians, but we don't live it out. And if we live it out, we live it out to a point where we cannot pass our comfort zone. We cannot go past a certain doctrine that we don't find, that we understand, and that can make sense in our head. We don't go past a certain way, if we can't live a certain lifestyle, I'm a Christian to that point. And God will be merciful and forgive us. We probably rationalize to ourselves. But Christ asks us to be perfect. He wants all of us, all our being, all our heart, all our soul. He does not just wish us to be on his lips. So we have to ask ourselves, what is it, brothers and sisters, that prevents us from going past our comfort zone to get into the kingdom of heaven? In this gospel, it was wealth. In other people's life, it's much other things. Some of those things I've already listed in those conversations that perhaps we had with loved ones and friends. Those things are barriers to the kingdom. Those things are barriers just to have a human life, oftentimes, just to be normal people who function in the world. And so we do it out of care and love for people. And so Christ does this to us out of care and love for us. He wants us to reflect today, what is it that has prevented me to go near him, to follow him? We all want to be near him, just as this man did in the gospel. We all want to be his followers. What is it that is stopping me from doing it totally and fully? Is it a relationship that I am in? Is it a habit that I partake of and I know that I should not have? Is it wealth? Is it entertainment? Things that I am addicted to? And this is what I think about all day long. My social media, my games. Is this all I do all day? Or do I actually live my life out as a Christian? Do I put that priority over anything else? And so today's gospel, brothers and sisters, is precisely that. Asking us to search into our hearts, to find that thing, it may be several things, but it's truly usually just one thing that is preventing us from taking the next big step to follow Christ. Now, we all have those conversations as I began the sermon with our friends and family. They're hard conversations to have. But you have to have that conversation with yourself, too. You have to ask yourself and tell yourself, I know this is preventing me to be a Christian. I know I should be. If you love your friends and your family enough to have that conversation with them, love yourself enough to have that conversation with yourself so that we can all, as this young man who set out on a good purpose, with good intent, follow Christ and know what it will take to get in the kingdom of heaven. Through God's mercy and his grace and his strength, may he give us the power to do this, to answer this question, and to have that conversation with ourselves. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.